you the latest, the juiciest, and the hottest entertainment news, mapalukal man o international. Yan ang ating damit sa inyo because here's a countdown. You shouldn't miss the new normal. You can't resist. Come on, let's start with number 10. All right, for number 10, we're going to talk about the Spider-Man director doing Final Destination. Bing, bing. Fresh from the success of Spider-Man No Way Home, director John Watts is already deep in the works for his newest project, another Final Destination movie. Also on board is wife Diane McGunigal, who's the producer, along with longtime Final Destination producers Craig Perry and Sheila Hanahan-Taylor. And of course, Final Destination is of the hit franchise movies that tells about a group of youth who escaped death until they found themselves getting into uncertain situations. Bing, bing, bing. Grabe, return of the 90s talaga ito. Back then, it had 5 installments that were released from 2000 to 2011. Well, guess what? Why to keep pala? Kala ko na, even 1996? So anyway, guys, Final Destination is set to be released on HBO Max soon. But okay, don't confuse this with I Know What You Did Last Summer, okay? Because it's different. And yeah, they're going to give you a different look this time for that. And let's see how they will revive an old story. All right, we didn't get to talk about this the whole weekend, but now, come on, let's give space for Kate Middleton and how fabulous she looks at 40. Honestly, her portraits are goals, really. I mean, I pinned it already, and I'm planning to do of that inspiration. Ding, ding, ding. It looks like, I don't know if you've been to, but you know when you go to castles and you see the portraits of old monarchs? Well, she is part of it, really. So they have achieved it in an old-fashioned and timeless way. Wow. Anyway, guys, the 3 new portraits, let me know ano yung favorite nyo doon, diba? Kasi one is full of color where she sports a red dress and her beautiful smile. The others were grayscale, depicting her timeless beauty and elegance. The community will have the opportunity to behold of the portraits as these will be shown in 3 places that were meaningful to her. The Berkshire Street and the Berkshire, St. Andrews, and Anglesey. And of course, it's going to be part of the National Portrait Nationwide Coming Home Edition. I wasn't such a favorite of the colored one, but it was still very beautiful. And it captured her in her natural habitat. All right, Gal Gadot to star in To Catch a Thief remake. Okay, so Gal is set to star in the remake of the hit thriller To Catch a Thief. And this news was revealed on Deadline. She will also be producing it with her partner Janin Verzano, as well as with Neil Moritz, who did the original film. To Catch a Thief was first released in 1955 under the direction of Alfred Hitchcock. It starred Cary Grant, who played the role of a former thief who was able to prove his innocence after being suspected of returning to his former act. Details about the story are yet to be announced, but you know, with Gal doing this with a husband, I mean, the husband is very influential back in their country, but I do know that it's really, really so accessible for stars, really, like Vin Diesel with the Fast franchise and all that, to become successful after just their acting gigs. I love it. And speaking of Gal, okay, so Netflix is plotting 2 Red Notice sequels. You heard it right. Netflix is doing not just one, but 2 sequels for Red Notice with Dwayne Johnson, Gal Gadot, and Ryan Reynolds. It is now the most watched movie of all time in the streaming platform. That is why it is no wonder that they are developing follow-ups for the project. Netflix hopes to commence the production in early 2023. Rawson Marshall Thurber will return as its director, according to Deadline. Though it earned negative reviews, well, Red Notice earned $328.8 million viewing hours, beating the 2018 thriller Bird Box starring Sandra Bullock with $282 million. Wow. All right. And of course, guys, pagka-comment ko pa sa negative comments, because good publicity, bad publicity is still publicity. And at the end of the day, it is the viewers who will win. Yep. Well, it was kind of unexpected, but SAG Awards did release their nominees. So that's the reaction of most netizens after the nominees for the Screen Actors Guild Awards were announced. Nominees for his outstanding performance by a cast in a motion picture are Belfast, Coda, Don't Look Up, yes, House of Gucci, and King Richard. Squid Game was nominated for outstanding performance by an ensemble drama series, and most of its lead stars got their respective nominations too. Some expected nominees made it to the list as well, but the biggest knob in the SAG Awards is Kristen Stewart for Spencer. Why? She wasn't nominated in Outstanding Performance by a Female Actor. Anyway, guys, fans and netizens were shocked not to see Kristen's name in the list, where Nicole Kidman, Olivia Colman, Jessica Chastain, Lady Gaga, Jennifer Hudson were included. So SAG will be on Feb 27 in L.A., Shrine Auditorium and Expo Hall. All right. So we're halfway on the show before we move on. Thank you so much, All Addicts Angels, for all the edits. Thank you, thank you. And for watching Everyday Celebrity Top 10, screenshotting this, Juan Balita Pilipinas, sa totoo lang, and inay ko po, lahat na, frontline, maraming salamat. So anyway, guys, we're 4:15 p.m. on 1PH with replays at 10 on 1 News. You know the drill. We have 1News.ph. Every Saturdays, I do have my column on the Philippine Star. Read up on it. I'm going to plug that every day as well, starting today. But halfway on the show, our local entry goes to Nadine Lustre on a rare moment introduced her boyfriend on Instagram. Nadine Lustre and Christophe Barriou are now Instagram official. Ding, ding, ding. This is the first time that Nadine posted a photo with him on IG. Christophe is a Filipino-French businessman who works in Siargao. Rumors between the two sparked last year as they were seen together at a few events, but it's the first time Nadine ever made a post about the dude, which is, I'm sure, it is serious already. Hello! They look awesome together, and I love how low-key the guy looks, right? I mean, I think he can handle Nadine. Kevin Peralejo stars as vampire in the Spongecola music video. So Kevin Peralejo stars as deeply conflicted vampire on the music video of Spongecola's Kung Ako Ang Humiling Tapusin Ito. That is the new single, which they dropped ahead of their full-length album to be released in 2022. The MV sees Heaven on the verge of a domestic breakdown as she adjusts to a life of uncertainty and fear from the sunlight. The music video serves as an allegorical take on walking away from an unhealthy, toxic relationship and finding the courage to love yourself. Despite the several changes in terms of shoot dates, the production team, headed by filmmaker Lamar Roque, covered all the bases, and it did go smoothly as planned. I love that, and it's good, Heaven. Ang daming trabaho, and she did get a condominium in BGC for herself. Congratulations. So Chris Aquino gave an update about her health. No one asked, but she did give an update because a lot are curious still. So she said she's far from okay, and that's how she is describing her current health condition. The TV host actress posted a series of photos and videos showing her getting an IV insertion. It is noticeable that she has lost more weight and is now only 40 kilos. Very, very alarming. Despite being sick, she insisted she was able to help Filipinos in time of the pandemic. Chris has been diagnosed with an autoimmune disease and revealed that in the late 2018. She has also made headlines just a few days ago after her breakup with, of course, former fiancé Mel Sarmiento. Well, Sue Ramirez is unstoppable after her projects on TV5. Now she plays the mistress Lexi in The Broken Marriage Vow. It is unstoppable for Sue Ramirez. She will do everything to destroy a married man's family that is as seductive mistress in ABS-CBN upcoming drama series The Broken Marriage Vow. She's playing Lexi Lucero. If you've a wealthy yoga instructor, which is accustomed to getting things her way. When she falls head over heels in love with David Illustre, who's played by Zanjo, she demands time, attention, and constant reassurance at the expense of his wife and only son. So Doctora Jill Illustre and Gio, roles played by Jody Santamaria and Zaijan Haranilia, respectively. And in one of the scenes in the series, Lexi talks to David about the future together, and Sweet talks him into breaking up with Jill. Well, kinuwento ko na, no?
Ding, ding, ding!
Well, basically, yung kasing plot ng, ano, no, ng World of the Mary, Dr. Foster, and now the Broken Marriage Vow. So that will air January 24 on TV5. Do stand by for it. Angel Luxin and Edo Anzano star in Pinoy adaptation of Call My Agent. So the hit French series Call My Agent will have a Philippine adaptation to be led by Angel Luxin and Edo Anzano with Eric Mati as director and showrunner. Variety reported that the production will start in April or May. It will be an 8-part series for HBO Go. Call My Agent is a comedy drama about a talent agent firm and the lives of people in it. So this will be Angel Luxin's comeback in acting after her last teleserye more than 2 years ago. Wow. Guys, before we end, just a general reminder for everybody to continue ensuring we're all safe from COVID-19. Wear a mask, disinfect, get boosted. Don't go out unless it's necessary, guys. And be equipped. Get your vitals, your vitamins up and be fit. Do your exercise. Yeah, you know, I'm like the mother who preaches this. You know the drill. Basically, just get well soon also for all our friends that are recovering right now from COVID and all the illness maybe that you're feeling. Anyway, guys, we love you. And we'll see you guys tomorrow here in Celebrity Top 10. 4:15 p.m. on One News with replays at 10 on 1PH. I'm MJ Marfori. Thank you so much for joining me. It's a pleasure. It's Friday tomorrow. It doesn't feel like it. Hello. But thank you. This is Celebrity Top 10. Ta-ta!